Hi guys, this is Grace Pamela, Summerana.com, and I'm going to show you how to upload or import your Lightroom presets into Lightroom CC, or also known as Lightroom Cloud. This is a little different from Lightroom Classic, which we already have a tutorial on how to do that. We also show you in that version how to upload your adjustment brushes. In this version, at the moment, they do not have a way to upload or use adjustment brushes. So I'm going to show you how to upload your presets. Okay, so when you first open, your Lightroom, you won't see your presets. So I'm going to show you really quick. I don't know how it'll look when you open yours, but all of it will have this on the side, and you'll see these are the different tools that you have in your toolbar over here. So in order to get to your presets, the first thing you're going to want to do is click up here, and this is where you're going to mainly edit your image. And then at the bottom, you will see presets, and you can go ahead and select that. And here you'll see if you have any already uploaded, or you'll see the default ones. If you want to delete any, you can right click and either hide it, or you can go to manage presets. Or if you right click, you can you'll have more options than some of them. You can delete group or whatever you need to do, but you can also hide them. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, I already have one installed right here, the Color May Fall presets. So then I'm also going to go up to these three little dots here, click that, and then here you can import presets. That's where you're going to want to go. That's where you're going to want to go if you want to import your presets. So go ahead and select that. Now it will open up your folder wherever you were last. So what you're going to want to do is make sure you know where you downloaded your presets and to find them on your computer. So let's say you put them on your desktop, then you're going to want to go to desktop, and then you'll be able to find your folder. The other thing is you cannot upload a zipped folder, so you're going to want to unzip it first. You can right click, and then whatever unzipping program you have, you're going to want to unzip it using that program. It's going to be different for each computer person depending on what you have for unzipping. Once it is done being unzipped, you can go ahead and select the presets, double click and go into that folder, and then you're going to want to select all of the ones that you want to upload. So if you just want to upload just a little bit, then do a little bit. If you want to upload all of them, then you can go ahead and select all of them and then go to import. It says it's loading the presets. Okay, so now you can see that it popped up right under here. Again, if you want to rename them, delete them, manage them, you can go ahead and do that. Now, I'm going to go ahead and open this up here so you can kind of see. All you do is hover over it and it will go ahead and set the adjustments for you. Now, one thing that you're going to want to note for when you're using presets, now, I'm not going to go over how to use all the presets and all the settings just because this is just a video on showing you how to import them. But I am going to show you really quick. There is something that happens if you have hide partially compatible presets clicked, then it might hide some of them that aren't exactly presets. So it might make it a little more disorganized for you. So one thing you're going to want to do is make sure that you have that unchecked, so that way all of your presets will show. I notice sometimes when I'm working on one image, some of the presets will be missing, and I'll be like, okay, where did those presets go? And then I'll try to, at first I was trying to re-upload them, and they still weren't showing up. So I figured that out. So I wanted to tell you so that doesn't happen to you. So again, just make sure that hide partially compatible presets isn't selected, and that might be what's doing that for you. Okay, so I think I pretty much went over the basics of how to import it. They make it very easy to do. If you have any questions at all, let me know, and you can contact me anytime, and I'll be happy to help. Okay, thank you so much for watching.